Perfect. Okay.
Now the important part.
The sparkling. Yeah, it's true. You already know a little bit of our wine.
Oh, yeah. I have them regularly. In fact, 2 days ago, I had the Ornati,
ecco.
Di Barbera.
Mm-hmm.
Just to get into the mood.
Hello, ciao.
Ciao, come stai? Ciao.
Bene, tu?
Bene.
Bene. Scusa, ma io non parlo inglese,
Yeah, and I don't speak Italian, but that's fine. That's fine.
No problem. No problem.
This is the important part, so
yeah.
I'm going to give myself a little sip.
Prego.
So first of all, thank you for having me, or me having you, or whatever it is. And just in time to congratulate you on the anniversary, 50 years. But it's not 50 years Paruso, right? It's 50 years of the Barolo DOC or DOCG, is that correct?
Well, it's 50 years from the first Paruso label.
Ah, yeah.
That my grandfather, the father of Marco, produced. So in 1971 was the first Barolo labeled by him.
The first Barolo, specifically.
Si.
Yeah, because the winery is older, right?
Yes, yes.
It's close to 100 years old.
Is the agricultural part, so it was more a farmer situation.
Okay.
So wine was into the facility as well, but was not the main activity.
Yes.
Before the 1970s, 1980s was not the main activity for our family.
Yeah. And when did you take over, Marco, from your father, I guess?
La mia prima annata è stata 86.
So his first vintage was 1986.
Okay. Yeah. Sounds like a good...
It's
almost as old as me, so that's good.
With the Paruso label, as you know, the label today. So now he show you how the labels change. So is the first label, the 1971. So actually, this is the anniversary one. This is the first label as the one you know today.
Exactly. Yes.
Different, but you recognize the logo.
86 ho fatto il primo Barolo, però 86 ho imbottigliato. Questo qua che era ancora un Barolo di mio papà che era 82.
So in 1986 he bottled and labeled his first Barolo, and the 82 was a Barolo, the first Barolo he labeled, but was a Barolo from his father.
Yeah.
So the first vinification he made by himself was 1986.
Yeah. Nice. Very nice. Before maybe we go into the past a little bit. We were originally, I think, supposed to have the meeting or what interview in early October, I guess, or something. But then,
of course,
the harvest is much more important. But I was wondering, because this year has been, I think specifically this year has been filled with all kinds of horror stories all over Europe, almost with very late frost and hail, and in part of Germany was flooded where I'm from. And I was wondering how that was in the at your sites. Did you have any specific climate change induced problems this year, or were you sort of safe from harm?
Volevo sapere quest'anno com'è andata dal punto di vista meteorologico, visto che sa che ci sono state in Europa in generale molte grandinate, molte gelate dalla parte della Germania dove viene lui, ad esempio, è stato perso parte del raccolto.
Qua siamo stati a sud delle Alpi, siamo stati più fortunati.
Where we are located at the feet of the Alps. So we were lucky. We were lucky.
They offer a lot of protection, of course.
Yeah.
Abbiamo avuto un andamento abbastanza secco, cioè poca pioggia.
We had a pretty dry year, so not a lot of rain. Mm.
Ci sono stati purtroppo dei temporali brutti che in alcune zone, per fortuna non qua da noi, ma poco lontano da noi, esempio a nord Piemonte, hanno fatto dei danni per grandinate.
There were many, many bad storms. Fortunately, we were not part of the area affected by those storms, but there are many areas that were affected by really, really bad hail. So they lost a part of the grapes or fruit because of
that. Piedmonte region as well.
Yeah. In the Roero, area.
Piedmonte.
In the north of the Piedmont, so there were really bad hail.
Forse la parte un pelino più sud, zona Barolo, ma verso Serralunga.
Yeah, maybe even something here in the Barolo district, but in the southern part, so closer to south Serralunga, something more, but not as in the Roero. Roero had a really bad storm.
Però comunque è stata un'annata con poca pioggia.
But in general we had less rain than the other years and few rains, so was pretty dry.
Questo il mio modo di vivere, ok, e non è mai piangersi addosso, non so come puoi tradurlo.
So how Marco is thinking is not stay there
no,
sad.
Non lamentarsi di quello che sta succedendo,
so
ma reagire
complain,
a quello che sta succedendo.
Being active and react to what is happening around him.
Yes, which is, I guess, viticulture in a nutshell, of course, to be quickly able to react to whatever happening in the larger.
È l'uomo che deve adattarsi ai cambiamenti e sicuramente non è la natura che si adatta a noi.
So he said that he's always the man that have to be adaptable and be flexible. So if we are talking about nature and not the opposite, so it's not nature that have to be adaptable in relation with man.
Quindi bisogna lavorare sulle piante per avere delle piante più dinamiche, più reattive, ok, lente ma reattive nello stesso momento.
So what we do is a lot of work with the vines, with the plants, because they have to be really reactive, really they have to change in a really fast way, but they have to be at the same time slow and relaxed.
Bisogna lavorare sulle diete, sugli apporti alimentari alle piante. Okay?
So what we do, we work with a sort of diet, that each plot have his own diet, his own, is a sort of nutrition based on the state of the roots, of the vines.
Per trovare che la pianta cerchi di avvicinarsi sempre a un equilibrio, no?
So this is to find a balance for the vines. So the vines have always to be in a sort of balance, sometimes more, sometimes less, but always to find a balance. Sì.
E poi dargli concorrenza, no? Ad esempio, noi la concorrenza la diamo seminando nelle vigne.
And then another important part for us is to give concorrenza,
competition
between the plants, and we can do that seeding herbs, many type of herbs.
Sì, yes, I saw that online on the website, etc. as well, which is also all over the world. You see so many arid, barren landscapes, and I'm always wondering where's, of course, you see the soil, but where is plant life? And it seems to me that in your vineyards there is actual plant life happening, which includes competition, but it also, I think, it also makes for leisure time for the plants, for a certain sense of happiness for the plant as well. So I think it's probably this balance between keeping a plant happy, but also making it compete with other elements surrounding it.
Sì, dice, molto spesso si vedono anche dei panorami, dei paesaggi molto belli, però magari non c'è vita poi nella pianta, no?
Sì, sì.
Invece in questi casi c'è proprio un voler mantenere la pianta felice e in salute, però allo stesso tempo una pianta che deve competere, che sì, ha sì. Oh, sempre un
è anche molto importante tutto gli insetti, no? Gli insetti, la microfauna, la microflora, no?
Yeah,
all'interno
so here,
della terra, no?
In this happiness how we can say to stimulate the plant, there are always insects, animals, micro fauna, micro flora, so everything that keep the plant, the organism, and the we can say the nature in that alive.
La parola chiave, ok, è dinamicità.
So the main word, the key word connected to our work and our philosophy is dynamicity, dinamicità.
Dinamicità delle piante, dinamicità degli uomini, dinamicità della tecnologia, dinamicità del vino che noi dobbiamo ottenere.
Is dynamicity of men's, dynamicity of vines, dynamicity of the soil, of the technology we use, we work with, and with the wine that we want to obtain.
Ovviamente il più possibile con rispetto, ok? Quindi cercare di inquinare il meno possibile, cercare di danneggiare la terra il meno possibile.
So we try to do that, to follow these key words, key concept, trying to be more sustainable as possible. So try to not put chemical stuff in the water, try to be more respect as possible in confront of the nature. So trying to be more sustainable as possible.
Ovviamente ci va un compromesso però, perché...
Of course, you have to look at the compromise. You have to work with compromise.
Which is the adaptation part, of course, of the entire
process.
Però lavorando con questo concetto dinamico, ovviamente questo ti permette di danneggiare il meno possibile, perché proprio il dinamico è quello che cerca di dare meno danno e quindi è capace a cambiare rapidamente il suo modo di pensare e di lavorare.
So the important thing connected to dynamicity even here is always to find a solution and try to not damage something. So if something change, you try in a fast, pretty fast way to change the situation and to not create a damage for something, someone, or in this case, ecosystem.
Yes. I also, as an extension to that, I also seem to remember that, Marco, you are one of the, let's say, pioneers in the area, at least, to use mother yeast when it comes to the winemaking. Could you elaborate or a little bit on that?
Che sei stato uno dei, se lui non ha capito male, uno dei primi nella zona a usare anche gli eliti naturali, fare questo lavoro un po' più
sì.
particolare. Beh, in cantina.
Allora, il concetto è che bisogna fare un vino alimento che abbia meno difetti possibili.
So even here the main concept, the key is try to produce a wine that have less defect as possible.
Yeah. La natura non è amica, ok? La natura tendenzialmente è nemica.
So nature is not a friend, is a sort of enemy.
Mm-hmm. Quindi in natura iniziano a lavorare prima i lieviti cattivi e poi i lieviti buoni.
So in nature normally the bad yeast start working and then the good yeast start working.
Yes.
Allora, se uno ha la capacità di gestire tecnicamente, okay, il prodotto, il mosto, l'uva, okay, per aiutare che i lieviti buoni lavorino velocemente e quindi vanno a sopravvalere sopra i lieviti cattivi, va bene non usare lieviti selezionati.
So if you have the modern technology or even the technology to select in some way this natural yeast, the good yeast, and you can use the natural yeast so they start working before the best yeast, this is good.
Quindi vuol dire controllo bene di temperatura, macro ossigenazione, okay?
So you can do that if you check and you control the temperature, mm-hmm. if you do some macro oxygenation.
Alimentazione precisa e giusta per i lieviti buoni.
the good nutrition even here for the good yeast.
E allora chi ha queste possibilità può permettersi di non usare lieviti selezionati.
And so people, so wine producers that have this possibility, this key, can use natural yeast, not selected yeast.
Ma nello stesso momento deve essere un tecnico obiettivo, che quindi se vede che c'è un problema deve intervenire rapidamente, perché se poi hai dei problemi, poi dopo devi sempre correre a recuperare e è probabile che hai dei difetti.
So, of course, have to be a technical enology that can see really fast if there is something that is not working well. Mm. Otherwise, then you have to do many changements, many things, and probably you will not have a clean and a proper wine at the end.
Quindi quando ho iniziato a fare il vino negli anni 80, non avevo tecnologia i primi anni e quindi ovviamente usavo lieviti selezionati perché non volevo rischiare di avere dei difetti che poi non potevo, che poi marcavano il mio vino in maniera negativa.
So at the beginning in the 80s, when he didn't have the proper technology as we have today, he used to use the selected yeast. So he started with selected yeast because he looked for, even there, a wine without defect. So without selected yeast, probably he couldn't obtain this type of wine.
Man mano sono riuscito piano piano a contemporaneizzare la mia tecnologia, quindi avrò una tecnologia di alto livello, una tecnologia dinamica, ok, che mi ha permesso di non usare più lieviti selezionati, ok.
So little by little he improved the technology he could work with. So until today, where we have a contemporary technology, a dynamic technology, where he can work without selected yeast.
È il grande problema che abbiamo oggi con questi vini, con questi produttori che si definiscono naturali, ma in natura non ci sono, la natura è cattiva, la natura produce odori e amaro, non produce dolce e profumato.
So nowadays, in fact, we have this sort of problem with all the natural wine because they follow natural in sense that, okay, you can work with nature, but you have to be clear that with nature, probably you will have many defects, many bad odors, because it's what naturally you obtain.
La natura ossida.
Okay. So nature, she did a work of oxidation.
Okay. Quindi va bene cercare una sintonia, una, come si dice, un aiuto con la natura, ma la natura di suo è cattiva, non è una natura, non è buona.
Okay. So it's good to find a balance, even there a compromise, a synergy with nature, but you have to be, even here, clear, because nature, naturally, if we say naturally, normally the bad things came first, and then the good one follows.
In natura la fermentazione è tumultuosa, quindi una cosa molto rapida e violenta, cioè e quando inizia a fermentare è molto violenta, quindi, e quindi porta degli squilibri enormi.
Okay. So naturally the fermentation is a tumultuous fermentation, so it's something that happens really fast, is not controlled, you cannot select or even choose what you want to obtain, and it take many, many different things. Most of them, they are not balanced, they are not good.
È come un animale selvatico. Okay.
So is that the same, we can do the same if we look to a wild animal.
Quindi devi educarlo per la contemporaneità, per dove devi adattare questo animale.
Okay. So if you need to work with this animal or have a sort of relation with this animal, you have to raise these animals and to adapt these animals to the environment when you want to put in.
Yeah, no, I completely agree. And as much, of course, the idea of natural wine, of course, it's a beautiful idea, but so a lot of them are in fact undrinkable, and they're almost proud of the fact that these wines are completely undrinkable, riddled with VA or Brettanomyces or whatever.
Dice you che know. lui gli piace molto l'idea del vino naturale.
Anche a me.
Però
anche a me piace.
Purtroppo non capisce questa cosa del fatto che tante volte vengono esaltati cose del Brettanomyces, cioè questi difetti che
anche
sono.
Anche a me filosoficamente mi piace il concetto del naturale, ma realmente la natura non è buona, la natura è cattiva. Se tu vai in mare, è probabile che non torni indietro dal mare, il mare ti mangia, ok? Se vai nel bosco uguale, se vai in alta montagna uguale, la natura non è buona.
Okay. So Marco share with you, he always loved the concept of natural wines, but if you look at the nature, you have to say that if you go to the seaside without equipment, without anything, probably you will not come back. The same if you go into the woods, probably you won't come back if you don't have some instrument to protect you. Or
se sei molto allenato, magari resisti un po' di più, ma se no, in ogni caso, vince il mare. Ok.
Maybe if you are a little bit more trained, you can survive a little bit more. But in any case, probably the sea or the woods will be stronger than you.
And it's again adaptability to that.
Yeah.
It's exactly the same thing.
In natura vince sempre l'acqua. Tu l'acqua non puoi fermarla. L'acqua non è possibile da fermare.
So in nature, normally, the one that always win is water. You cannot stop water.
Quindi tu puoi gestirla, organizzare un corso d'acqua, ma se non continui di continuo a organizzarlo e a gestirlo, al primo momento che tu rallenti questo controllo, vince di nuovo, l'acqua passa di nuovo dove sempre è passata.
So maybe you can in some way find some argine and organize the river, the flow of the water, but if you don't control the flow of the water, probably you will lose everything and water will go where she won't go.
Yeah. And of course, winemaking, I mean, wine is spoiled grapes, but winemaking is to control the spoilage of the grapes. And it's the control aspect that is actually that's the talent of the winemaker, to control something. And if you say, well, I'm not going to control anything, I'm going to let it do whatever it wants, then you're not actually the winemaker, are you? You just stood there and let nature do its thing, and then it doesn't matter whether it's good or bad.
Insomma, il ruolo poi del produttore dovrebbe essere quello anche di controllare il processo.
Deve gestirlo.
Quindi se tu sei lì invece che non fai nulla, tutto lui, e tu cosa fai? Non sei il produttore.
In natura il vino non esiste. Il vino naturale, ok, è aceto che puzza, che non ha un buon odore.
So naturally, if we say naturally wine doesn't exist, because what we find in nature is vinegar.
Sì. Yes. Il vino è una situazione intermedia, evolutiva, ok, instabile, che quindi l'uomo deve gestire.
Sì, so wine is something in the middle that man, so someone from the external world, have to organize and work, no?
In natura non ci sono le vigne, ci sono i boschi selvaggi dove tu non riesci a entrare dentro.
You don't have vineyards. You have wild forest where you probably, if you don't clean or you don't organize the forest, you cannot even go inside.
Quindi questo concetto venduto come naturale è un concetto falso, non è un concetto realistico, non è un concetto contemporaneo, ok? In natura l'uomo vivrebbe pochi anni, l'età media dell'uomo era molto bassa.
So what they want to pass with this concept of nature is something that is not realistic, is not contemporary to the epoch where we are living now, no? Because even if we look at the man's life, back then, man's life was 20-30 years less than today, no? But why? Because of medicine and all what we have to have a longer life.
Quindi la contemporaneità è fondamentale.
So the contemporary concept is probably the most important one, to live in the epoch where you are, no?
Absolutely. Oggi io sono spaventato, perché questo movimento del naturale, okay, oggi mi fa assaggiare dei vini che mi sembrano i vini degli anni 70, di 50 anni fa.
Okay. So he said that he's scared sometimes of this natural movement, this natural wine, because what he tastes are wines that are the same of the 50-60 years ago.
Ma chi di noi tornerebbe nel bagno di 50 anni fa? Okay. Chi di noi userebbe la macchina di 50 anni fa?
So, but who among us will go back to the toilet, to the bathroom they used to have 50 years ago, or the cars they used to have 50 years ago? Maybe some of them they will love to, but maybe for 1 week, and then if they have the
other bagno di 50 anni fa era un bagno molto evoluto rispetto a quelli di 100 anni fa. Okay.
Yeah, of course, the bathroom of 50 years ago was much more advanced compared to the one of 100 years ago.
Io oggi sto assaggiando dei vini che hanno dei difetti, hanno dei problemi, come i vini di 50 anni fa, ma 50 anni fa non c'era la possibilità.
So what he's tasting today are wines that have the same defect they used to have 50 years ago. Mm. But 50 years ago was okay because they couldn't have the technology, they couldn't manage as they can do today the process.
Yes, yes. Well, having said that, I'm going to have a sip of the
Sure, yeah.
Metodo classico.
Metodo classico. Questo è un metodo classico che possiamo definirlo antico, con il concetto antico ancestrale.
So we love to describe our metodo classico with the ancestral and ancient methodology concept.
Con tecnologia però, cioè io posso riutilizzare questi, posso riapplicare questi concetti antichi che si sono autoestinti, si sono annullati perché davano dei problemi, quindi il concetto industriale ha risolto questi problemi. Io oggi applico di nuovo questi concetti antichi perché ho tecnologia di gestione di questi concetti antichi.
So what he can do is apply those ancient concepts that during the time they went lost because something new born, but he can reintroduce these ancient concepts because he can work with them with technology. So he can adapt them to the modern technology, to the modern life, and he can produce this type of wine.
And again, it's about adaptation. It's about adapting to the current state of things, be it in the vineyard or in the cellar or wherever.
Fino a 70-80 anni fa era normale raccogliere l'uva e aspettare che maturasse al 100% e farla riposare. Ok. Ovviamente questa era una cosa pericolosa. Poi il sistema industriale piano piano ha detto ok, non fare più riposare l'uva, ma lavora rapidamente e togli il raspo, okay? Che è la parte che dava delle negatività.
So one of these ancient concept is that in the past they used to harvest and then wait a few days for a rest. That was not an overripening, was just a rest. And then they used to do the vinification and all the process. Then with the industrial time, what they do? They say, no, these take too long. We have to do this faster. So harvest and vinification, that's it.
Without il raspo.
And no stamps. So this was a bad part of it.
Però praticamente oggi vinificano dell'uva che non è matura al 100%.
Okay. But what happened? They normally do a vinification with grapes that are not properly ripe as they could be.
L'uomo sapiens invece sapeva che l'uva doveva raccoglierla, che si poteva ancora trasportare, quindi doveva essere ovviamente consistente.
The Homo sapiens knew that grapes, as the other fruit, have to be harvested, transportable, so in a state that were ripe, but not 100% ripe.
E poi aspettava qualche giorno che l'uva diventava matura al 100%, che ovviamente diventava fragile e non più spostabile, non più trasportabile.
And then, with few days, maybe 3, maybe 4 days, there was a second maturation. So the grapes or the fruit in general weren't transportable anymore because they were too delicate and they were 100% ripe and they were finally ready to be vinified or processed.
Il sistema industriale moderno dice vendemmia l'uva trasportabile, quindi che non è matura ovviamente.
So the modern technology, the industry say harvest the grape when it's transportable, so not 100% ripe.
Togli la parte negativa in quel momento che è il raspo vegetale.
Took away the negative part that at this time, at this moment is the vegetal part, so the stems.
E poi fai un prodotto che ovviamente devi aggiustare, perché non se tu hai fatto un succo di banane verdi gialle o un succo di arance dure, e poi puoi solo aggiungere o dello zucchero, togliere dell'acidità per trovargli un equilibrio, ma non ha un equilibrio naturale.
And then you do the vinification or the juice in general, but of course you have to modify that juice, because maybe you have to add a little bit of sugar or to have to
togliere l'acidità,
low down the acidity,
togliere i tannini vegetali,
took away the green tannins, mm-hmm, because the grape was not properly ripe, so you will do a not proper juice.
Voglio l'esempio della banana.
We can see this example that was always Marco explain with the banana, no? So if you normally see, they harvest bananas when they are yellow green, because mm-hmm, they are transportable maybe by the plane, by the boat or whatever. So when you go to the market, normally you buy a banana that is yellow green, but if you eat that banana, you will eat a really, really tannic banana,
exactly,
probably not juicy, not sweet. The energy is really low. It's difficult to digest even. Mm-hmm. If you wait a few days, normally the few days you wait at home, the banana turn into yellow brown. So you will taste a sweet banana. You will taste an energetic banana, so you will obtain the energy that the sugar of that banana have developed, have derived, and you will probably digest it.
I tannini diventano polimerizzati, dolci e buoni, con potere antiossidante.
So tannins became polymerized, so they became active, and they have the power they had.
Diventa un alimento con una resa al 100%.
So it became a food that is 100%.
Se tu fai un succo di banane verdi gialle, puoi far quello che vuoi, non potrà mai diventare come quell'alimento là.
So if you do a juice from the yellow green banana, you will have a juice that you cannot adapt later. So will, yes, not be the same as the yellow brown banana juice. And you couldn't transform into the yellow brown banana. You can modify to have a similar juice, but it would not be the same juice.
Questo è fondamentale, questa cosa. Quindi i nostri vini, la più parte, sono fatti con uva riposata, perché vogliamo fare un succo d'uva che sia al 100%.
So most of our wines are made following this ancient technique with the rest of the grapes, because we want to do a juice that then is a wine that is 100% juice.
Yeah. Fondamentale questa cosa.
And this is so important. Unfortunately, all these ancient techniques, most of them with the industrialization, were lost or were put in the background because were longer or maybe you had more risks. So
sì. E quindi sono state tecniche cancellate, no?
So they were canceled.
Noi oggi l'abbiamo ripresa questa tecnica perché abbiamo la possibilità di avere di vendemmiare in un certo modo, raccogliendo l'uva perfetta, farla, trasportarla bene e aiutarla a arrivare alla maturazione 100% in una camera dove noi possiamo fare freddo, caldo, ma tendenzialmente più verso il caldo.
So today we can apply this ancient technique to our philosophy because we are able to do a harvest with transportable and pretty ripe grapes. We move them into rooms in our cellar where we have temperature, humidity, ventilation under control, so we can control the 3-4 days of rest. And then we have all the modern technology that allowed us to bring from this from that product all the best.
Yeah, it's interesting because, of course, Nebbiolo specifically has a very powerful tannic structure, which often takes a long, long time to fully integrate into the wine. Mm-hmm. Having said that, I'm going to start with the
yes,
Nebbiolo.
In no 18. You have the 18.
This is the 18. 19. Sorry, the 19.
Io ci voglio chiedere. Sì, tu gli spieghi che i nostri tannini sono così morbidi e dolci perché sono polimerizzati.
Sì.
Ok, noi lavoriamo sulla polimerizzazione. Quindi noi abbiamo tanti tannini, ma dolci e fini. Invece, chi non fa questa lavorazione ha pochi tannini duri, che quindi sembra che il vino sia molto, molto superbo, molto che tu devi aspettarlo, ma non ha la finezza. Arrivo al
più. So, He's coming back in 5 minutes. What he was saying is that maybe you will ask it, because we were talking about tannins, that our Nebbiolo have those sweet tannin, you will taste it right now, those ripe tannin, and this is due to the fact of the rest that allowed us to use the stems. So normally with the Nebbiolo and the Barbera, we use part of them, 60-70%. With the Barolo, you will see it with our Per Armando and with our Riserva especially. Most of the time we use the whole part. So we do a whole cluster fermentation, is 100% of tannin, of stems, and so 100% of polymerized tannins.
Mm-hmm. Is that true for the lung? Now I'm having the...
Yeah, yes.
Is that 100% or partially?
The Barolo is around 60-70%. With all the Barolo, we do all cluster fermentation. So actually it's 100% of tannin.
That's beautiful. I always like that. I like bold tannins. But if they're well integrated, of course. And that's something that even with the, of course, that is slightly less tannic, but even with the Barbera, it was that was a 2018 vintage, but the tannins were already so beautifully integrated. It was, and there were elements to it that reminded me almost of a very fine Pinot Noir.
Mm-hmm.
And that's something that I find very interesting, because there is still, there's a rustic element to the wine, which I think is a good thing. I have to say that in the world of wine, the word rustic has become sort of like a bad thing. And I think...
It depends.
And it very much depends. And I think with a good Barolo has to be in part rustic. And there are some regions in the world, I have to say, I'm quite, you know, I think Greek wine is also very good very often with balancing, like Xinomavro, which is often referred to as a Greek Nebbiolo, where there has to be a balance between rusticity and elegance.
Mm-hmm.
Especially, I think that's important when you pair it with food. Specifically, then an element of rusticity is actually a very, very good thing to have. And I think a lot of places in the wine world, I regret to say that, especially in New World wines, that element is so stripped down that it feels like things have been taken away from the wine just in order to make it more drinkable.
Mm-hmm.
But there's nothing to think about when drinking the wine. And I think...
Yeah, sure. It loses character in some way.
A wine that doesn't make you think, I wouldn't want to drink. It's a bad rhyme, but that's basically how it is.
Yeah, no, it's true. Because it's like they are losing their aim, not to be...
An essence, a certain sense of sense of place.
In a person, no? We can do the same with a person. So maybe you want to do something that is closer to perfection in sense of no defect and whatever, but you lose the characteristic, the part that they are not the bad one we were talking before.
Yeah.
The one that can be bad, but if you are able to work with them, you can adapt them, control them. So it's something characteristic, controlled, that could be bad, but in that way is a element that together with the others create balance, no? It is something more. It's something that increase maybe the power and even the I don't know how to say, but the characteristic of that wine, no? The personality of that wine.
Exactly, the personality, exactly. Yes.
Diceva, diciamo un po' che lui, ad esempio, una parte che spesso trova che nei vini si toglie, che invece a lui piace, che sia ovviamente ben bilanciata, è un po' quel sentire anche del rustico, no? però nel senso che come in questi vini magari è una cosa che tu percepisci positivamente perché è stato controllato, no?
Sì.
E invece tante volte o è, come dicevamo prima, che diventa negativo, o è troppo artefatto e quindi poi è un vino che non è neanche più interessante.
Non ha personalità. No? Sì.
And even with this Nebbiolo now, it's such a beautiful harmony between all those very floral notes and those very delicate, again, delicate veering towards Pinot Noir almost element.
Il Nebbiolo nostro gli ricordava molto un Pinot Noir come caratteristica.
Some
e quello
trova
molto
like
equilibrio tra questi aspetti più floreali e la frutta. Lo trova molto equilibrato.
And obviously also, again, considering it's such a young wine, the oak is so well integrated. The oak never overpowers, and that's another thing that in modern winemaking you see too often.
L'integrazione del legno è data molto dal fatto che questi vini maturano sui suoi lieviti, ok? Su tutti i suoi lieviti fini che noi facciamo digerire di nuovo il vino e quindi vanno a dare questo, vanno a portare questo equilibrio, questa cremosità, questo legante.
So in our wines you will see the oak so well integrated because we leave the indigenous yeast together with the wine during the aging, all of it.
Battonaggio.
And we normally do once a month at the beginning, now then less, the battonage on all of them, all the Barolo, the Barbera Superiore, the Bollicina,
facendo
a white we
coup
do.
De poignet. Okay.
So this is so important because all the natural yeast became part of the wine again, digest by the wine, thanks to the autolisi process, and you find all these creamy aspect, this roundness, then translate into the wine.
Absolutely. It's not only a flavor thing, it's also the texture. No. It's so beautiful. It's such a, as you said, creamy, velvety texture, which is such a lovely combination with the high tannins. They're not rough, they're not coarse. It's
we can say that the batonnage technique combine together with the rest, it of course one help the other, so it's something that give power to the other technique, and together they combine this roundness together with what you are saying, the tannins. That even when the wine, you will see it, especially with the Barolo, of course, the wine is really young, but is drinkable.
I'm headed there right now. I was going to spit, but because it's relatively early, but I'll be fine.
Già voleva sputare perché è abbastanza presto, ma andrà bene così.
Lui dov'è? Lui a Berlino.
You live in Berlin, right?
I live in Berlin, yes, yes.
A Berlino.
Adesso lui forse sta assaggiando il
sì,
Barolo.
You are tasting the Per Armando, right?
Un po' la storia di Per
Now, Armando. Yes, exactly. The 2017.
Actually, our Barolo, the white label, so our classic Barolo, took the name Per Armando only this year, so the 2017, because it occurs the 50th anniversary. So before,
of course,
2016 and in the past, it used to be just Barolo with white label. From this year and now on, our Barolo Classic will not be Barolo Classic, will be Per Armando, dedicated to Armando, that is the father of Marco and my mother, to honor all the work he has done and even to celebrate from the label he created, so from the start point where the vinery then go on.
Yeah.
So you will see from the 2017 on the Per Armando. 2017 was a pretty, we can say, particular vintage because we had less quantity than the previous year. not bad quality, but only was a question of quantity. And when it's like that, we decide, we do it even in other years, and as the 2014, 25, 22, so all difficult vintage due to the quantity or quality, it depends, that affect our production, and normally took us to consider it just one Barolo. So in the normal vintage, as was the 2016 or will be the 2018 available in a few months, we produce the classic Barolo, so Barolo per Armando, we produce Barolo Mariondino,
single vineyard di Castiglione,
single plot, single vineyards in Castiglione Falletto that maybe you know.
Yeah, I had it recently, yes.
Ah, ok, te l'ha assaggiato di recente.
Ah, ok, dici che poi magari tra un po' gli mandiamo
yeah, maybe in a few months, maybe in January, we can have a tasting, we can send you the preview of the Barolo 18, because you didn't taste the single cru, because in 17 we hadn't. Yeah. We have Mosconi, Barolo Mosconi, South Monforte d'Alba, and we have the most important cru, Bussia, that is made of two different single vineyards, one located in front of the winery, Vigna Rocche, and one behind, Vigna Mugne. And so in the Barolo per Armando, you find all of them. In the normally, the normal vintage, we have a selection on the Mariondino, a selection on the Mosconi, and a selection on the Bussia. And what is not select on those single label is assembled in the Barolo Classico per Armando.
And then, of course, there's the Bussia Reserva, the Oro.
And then there's the Bussia Reserva. Bussia Reserva have always been with gold label.
Yeah.
We produce the Reserva only in the best vintage, and we decided to release our Reserva after 10 years, 9-10 years.
Yes, this I have the 12 here 12, now, so it's very,
that we
very
sold out,
excited.
1 month ago. So we start with the 13 in 1 month, more or less. Why we release the Reserva after 10 years? Because we want to show, to demonstrate that our wines are so easy to drink and so easy to approach earlier as they will be with the aging. Because most of the time, one of the most critic part is that some journalist or some other producer or whatever, they say, okay, you are doing those easy to drink Barolo, but then they will be done in a few years. No. Because this here, this technique helps you to drink the Barolo when it's really young, because it seems older. Yeah. And then when it will be older, it will be difficult to say how old is he, because you will see with the Reserva, it tastes really young. So it's difficult to say it's 10 years old. And when they say to you it's 10 years old, you cannot even trust, no?
Of course, yeah.
And so until the 2012, we have just one Reserva. From the 2013, so this vintage on, we will release the Reserva as Barolo Bussia Reserva Vigna Rocche, Barolo Bussia Reserva Vigna Mugne. They will look the same as the golden label, as this one, but they will be divided. So as we do in the past, because in the past, before the 1999, more or less, we used to do two Reserva, Vigna Mugne and Vigna Rocche. We used to divide them because they are actually different. So, and then to conclude, as the explanation of the Barolo lineup, we have this new entry that actually is an old one, that is the Barolo 2000. Because always doing this, so to explain our wines are never ending, we can say age, they have not an age, we decided to release as the first one, the 20 years Reserva. Now, from now on, we will release some of them. We have the 2003, the 2007, and they are released after 20 years. So 2 years of oak as the others, and then all the aging here in our cellar in bottle. Before we release these 2000, we open all of the Magnum, because we are selling just Magnum and big format, not bottles. We taste all of them. They were around 700. And then we recork them as with new the uncork as guarantee. And was a big work, because in 2000 we didn't use DM already, so there were some that were not perfect anymore.
Yeah.
And we did it because this reserve, of course, is a prestigious reserve, so have to be perfect, no, if someone buy it. And is dedicated to Francesco, that is the first son of Marco, my cousin, that is working in the company as well, most in the vineyards. That is from 2000. So actually, this is vintage dedicated to him for that reason.
So the 17 smells absolutely delicious.
It's really nice. When they are all blended together, it seems at the beginning, of course, it seems is more balanced, no? Because they have many different aspects from many different plots. And together combined, they seem maybe more ready to drink than the single vineyards.
Absolutely. Yeah, absolutely.
Da averle dopo, magari prima che chiudiamo le sistemiamo già.
Lui al 2012.
Sì, lui li aveva il Per Armando 17 2012.
No.
Sì.
Wow. So in case you're wondering, I started with this one. So when did you first start producing the Oro label?
99.
Oh, it's relatively young.
Yeah. 99.
Yeah, and what was the occasion for it then? What was the thought behind it?
E perché hai iniziato?
Allora, questa cosa è iniziata perché, come diceva lui prima, la nostra azienda è stata etichettata come un'azienda moderna. E quindi nell'ambito di chi, quando uno pensa al moderno, pensa a una cosa rapida, veloce, da consumare giovane, che poi però alla maturazione, visto che i vini sono così facili già giovani, allora non durano nel tempo. Allora questo è stato proprio per far capire che invece il mio concetto di dare dinamicità a un prodotto vuol dire che quando è giovane è maturo, è pronto e poi invecchia molto lentamente. Quindi quando sarà maturo, sembrerà che paradossalmente sia diventato giovane.
So what we were talking about, essentially. So because as we say before, Marco and our winery was a little bit labeled as modern, and that for many means something that finish in fastly, no? So you can have it when it's young, but then no future for it. Actually, the concept that for Mark is really important here came again. Dynamicity is something that you give to the wine that help the wine being adaptable, dynamic when it's young, but at the same time aging it will not lose this dynamicity, no?
Yes.
So it will be difficult to judge how old is he, and many other characteristics connected to the age. So it was a sort of demonstration, a proof that tasting is something that explained by itself, no? So it's not something that you have to, if you hadn't the label that was a blind tasting, for example, of the 17 and the 12, maybe, of course, you can say that the 12, because of the softer and sweeter tannins, is a little bit more age and ready. But will be a great challenge to say how old they are.
Yeah, it's such an interesting. I mean, I'm still young, and I'm already to a large degree fed up with this entire idea that you should never drink wine young. It's almost like wine. Good wine has to be an investment.
See.
And that's it. But wine should be about drinkability. It should be about the pleasure of opening a wine, not only the pleasure of storing a wine for 30 years until it is sort of drinkable.
Lui infatti è molto sempre stato molto combattuto anche con questo concetto, no? Mm-hmm. Che il vino è fatto per essere stoccato, cioè nel senso che non lo devi bere da giovane, un investimento che poi lo berrai, no? Così. Però in realtà appunto lui condivide questa cosa che il vino deve essere una cosa che cioè che si adatta, che deve essere bevibile.
Sì, è ovvio. Sì, il concetto è proprio legato al rapporto con l'ossigeno, ma non solo del vino. Del ferro, del legno, okay? Di tutti i prodotti strutturalmente importanti, no? E quindi se uno riesce ad avere questo rapporto importante con l'ossigeno, no? Quindi prima sei amico dell'ossigeno, prima sei maturo e poi il tuo invecchiamento sarà lento. Questo lo diceva già Pasteur a metà dell'Ottocento, no? Questo concetto. Quindi dà una bevibilità al prodotto vino, al materiale legno, al materiale ferro molto più lunga.
So basically is what we were saying before, no? The oxygen is the most important part, is the most important element, not only for wine, for all the structural elements, as we can consider iron or wood, even wood, no? So before, as we know, previously you came friend, with oxygen, more he can help. He can help you to become more adaptable, more strong, more resilient. So it's the same, not only with wine, but with if you have a structure of iron or wood, if they are well done and they have a good relation with oxygen, they will be more. More stronger, more powerful, no? They will be more more adaptable.
Again, adaptable, yes. Yeah.
Che lo riassumi proprio in dinamicità.
Okay, and you can resume this concept with dynamicity. So, dynamicity.
Dare dinamicità a un prodotto. Quello che avviene nel legno, cioè un legno stagionato all'aria, non alla pioggia, è un legno che poi invecchia molto più lentamente, quindi durerà molto di più.
So we can say the same as with wood. So a wood that was aged at the air but not under rain, so covered but at the air, will be a wood that aged with longer time, no? So will be more
la stessa cosa
efficient.
Viene con il ferro, no? Con
so
il ferro che si chiama corten.
The iron, with the corten.
Che è la stessa cosa, è un ferro iperossigenato da giovane e quindi poi avrà, cioè, marcisce e matura molto più lentamente.
So as the corten iron, that is a hyper-oxygenated iron, that will be a longer shelf life because will be slower in the damaging and aging part.
No.
Questo 2012, vuoi parlare un po' dell'annata 2012? Yeah. Che è un'annata molto elegante.
So we personally like a lot the vintage 2012. Is a really, really elegant vintage. Was a pretty warm vintage, so we like when we have a warm vintage because we can have many information, we can have many details that maybe in the colder vintage you lose faster. So we can have a product with more information to digest and then to transform into final product. So for us, the 12 was a really great vintage. We personally like it a lot.
It's beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful. And it's, again, it's so wonderfully elegant without losing the, for me, necessary, slightly rustic touch to it. Mm-hmm.
Dice per lui, appunto, gli piace molto, molto elegante, però secondo lui c'è sempre questo, senza perdere il suo carattere, no? Lui la chiama rusticità, però intende proprio la sua personalità, no?
Ma è importantissimo, perché il mio sistema di lavoro vuol dire sfruttare lui al 100%, okay? Quindi prendere tutte le notizie che ha. Con la tecnologia estraiamo il più possibile, e con il legno fissiamo il più possibile. Quindi noi abbiamo tante notizie, però dobbiamo poi renderle, cioè creare una squadra, creare un'armonia, creare un coro. Okay?
So in fact it is probably what you say, no? Even the rustic part, because we have so many information to collect. First of all, from the vineyards, the one we took in the winery. Then with the vinification, so with our modern technology, we have to start fixing them. With the aging, we have other information. With the batonnage, we have other information to digest and to absorb into wine. But then at the end, we have all this information that have to be a sort of team, so they have to be balanced. And they have to work together, no? So there, you need a harmony between all these elements, all this information you collect.
La squadra, il concetto è creare squadra.
Yeah, so the concept is to create, even in the vineyards with the diet concept, to create a team that work many different elements that work together and create a balance of the macro system.
Quindi più abbiamo il terroir importante, più hai l'annata importante, ok? Più ovviamente è difficile trovare questo grande equilibrio perché hai tante cose da mettere.
So the terroir is really important, but then the vintage, when you have a big and important vintage, the work is more difficult because you have more information and more stuff to put together and to combine and then find the balance between all these elements.
Sì, infatti in alcune annate che abbiamo questa difficoltà a trovare questo super equilibrio magari nelle singole vigne, preferiamo di non fare le singole vigne, di fare il per Armando.
So in fact, in the vintage where we have some difficulty finding this balance, most of the time connected to the vintage, we decide to not do the single plot, the single vineyards, but the per Armando, because will be easier to find the balance and to find a harmony between all of three.
Sì, molto importante.
And this is really, really important even to understand, we can say, the philosophy behind our work, no? Because sometimes you want to do the cru, even if the vintage is not the best, and then maybe you have three products that are so-so, no? And was better to do only one Barolo at the top with all the good stuff together, well-balanced, than three that maybe are not at the best, no?
Questi infatti i nostri vini sono dei vini che le bottiglie lui può tenerle aperte ed è bello che lui provi, ok? Di assaggiarsi questi vini. Adesso le tappe le tiene al fresco, tra due giorni le riassaggia, tra quattro giorni le riassaggia, tra sei giorni le riassaggia, tra otto giorni le riassaggia e vedrà come questi vini hanno un'evoluzione lenta ma proprio costante, no? Perché sono stati preparati, allenati a questa cosa.
So, you can prove even the concept of oxygen and how they change with time because you have the bottles. So for you will be interesting to record them.
Oh, absolutely. Even, yes. I will retry them in the next couple of days. Yes.
Even with the sparkling you have.
Yeah, absolutely.
Take them in a cooled place because it's
meglio frigo,
maybe is even better fridge than outside if you don't have a cold place, and then taste them tomorrow a little bit in 2 days, in 1 week, because and you
anche
will see
giorni,
even 10 days you will see how even the Nebbiolo, so even the more easy to drink wine, you will see how they evolve, how big the evolution is and how they change when they become in contact with the oxygen.
Or sempre in equilibrio avverrà questo.
Okay. Yeah, but you will see they will be always be balanced. So okay. They will change, it will be different, but they will be balanced at
first. Sono nati, allenati e cresciuti con questo concetto di essere dinamici.
Because they born and they were trained with this concept of be dynamic.
And again, adaptable, yes.
Again, be adaptable.
No.
Lui viene in Piemonte?
You have in plan to come to Piedmont?
Actually, I do, with my dog and girlfriend, next either spring or late summer.
Okay.
I'm not sure yet, but probably we will be traveling from That's the current plan. You never know. From Pula, Croatia, across northern Italy to south of France, and then go up again. So we might actually see each other.
You have to stop by, eh?
If we manage, we will absolutely drop by. Yes, absolutely.
You're welcome.
Yeah. È interessante se adesso lui vuole riassaggiare un attimo la bollicina finale.
Sì, would be interesting at the end of the tasting of the Barolo to taste again the sparkling.
That's true. Yes, there's actually still.
Perché vede che farà di nuovo da legante alla conclusione di questa degustazione di tutto Nebbiolo.
Because you will see that will be how took together all these Nebbiolo personality.
I found that interesting at the beginning already, how clear the Nebbiolo comes through in the sparkling wine, which I find very admirable. Mm-hmm. That's very, very interesting.
Ma so, la personalità di questo Nebbiolo, di questa bollicina, è proprio data dal fatto che la seconda fermentazione avviene non con zucchero neutro, ma avviene con un mosto di uva appassita e quindi concentrata, che quindi gli dà questo carattere, che gli porta Nebbiolo, gli porta profumi, gli porta colore, gli porta eleganza, gli porta grande personalità.
So what you find is because during the second fermentation we don't add sugar, we had a concentrate must of Nebbiolo from a sort of Nebbiolo passito that take into the wine this Nebbiolo characteristic, the color, the acidity, the tannic part,
lo zucchero per la seconda
fermentazione,
the sugar
that of course is important to end the second fermentation. So is this concentrate must that actually give this personality and this strong Nebbiolo personality.
Absolutely.
To this sparkling.
Absolutely. The soil and the flower petals are very, very prominent.
Strong.
Questa bollicina va bene all'inizio, ma va molto bene anche alla fine.
In fact, normally we don't say it's better at the beginning or at the end, because it's really nice to start the tasting, especially if it's a Nebbiolo theme tasting, with the sparkling. But then it's even nice to end it or to taste again, as you are doing, at the end, because you don't lose the tannin of the Barolo you have tasted. You only clean, no? And you, in some way, exalt the tannic of the Nebbiolo.
And that's another thing. It's surprisingly tannic as well, which fits to the Nebbiolo, of course, but not in a distracting way at all. It's in complete balance and harmony with the other elements.
C'è questo tannino che però non è un elemento di distrazione, no? Mantiene
perché?
Questo...
Perché questo? Okay. Perché sia questa bollicina che tutti i vini che abbiamo assaggiato maturano integralmente, nel caso di questa bollicina sono quasi più di 40 mesi, con i suoi lieviti. Okay? E noi qua facendo questo coup de poignet, quindi questo battonaggio in bottiglia, i lieviti vanno in autolisi e vanno a riempire, a legare, a morbidire, a fare squadra.
Okay? So, but why this? Because this sparkling as all the Barolo, all the wines, aged together with the mother yeast, with the yeast, no? And so all these, for this sparkling, we have almost 40 months together with the yeast. And so we have all this creamy, all this roundness, again, as you used to taste before, no? And they together create this steam, this core. And this is really nice because then the final product is so elegant and so well balanced, no?
Absolutely. Yeah. I was hoping my dog would say hello, but she's sleeping. I think you can see her that thing.
Because we have the square.
Okay. Next time. Or, if I do stop by next year,
Sure.
My dog.
But have you been here in Lange region?
Sorry? No, I haven't been there. No, unfortunately not yet. I mean, passing through, yes, but we never stopped except to have an espresso in a gas station driving through. But that's...
Oh, you have to come. Because it's
that's
really
about
nice.
To change. Yes, absolutely.
Non è mai stato qua. Solo di passaggio non è stato qua. Solo di passaggio.
Quando avrà occasione.
Se ha detto probabilmente in primavera.
Sì, okay. Se poi adesso lui ha delle questioni, delle domande, può scriverti,
può
chiederti. Yeah, of course,
if you have extra questions, something that you want to clarify, you can send me an email with your doubts or only if you need information generica, even that we didn't talk about history or whatever.
Absolutely. That you really or didn't we keep that for well. Part two next year. That's also an
yeah.
option.
When you come,
lui che
yeah.
tipo di comunicazione fa?
Which type, because you tell me a little bit already that you are doing this sort of documentary, but which type of communication do you do?
You mean on social media?
In general, so as you are a journalist only about wine and then you are translated into a documentary and one video making or even articles?
Well, currently it's mainly a YouTube channel.
Mm-hmm.
That's the main output at the moment.
Okay.
We'll see how that goes, mm-hmm. but that's the main thing at the moment. Yes.
Principalmente YouTube, il canale YouTube. Ah, okay. So sta valutando come organizzarli, però principalmente YouTube.
Okay. Yeah. Lui fa già questo. Vino in generale, su vini
a tedeschi. You are doing this on wine in general already, maybe with German wine.
It's wine in general, although my main focus so far has been Greek wine.
Ah, soprattutto I'm, sui vini greci.
Yeah, mainly. But I mean, you have to expand a little bit, obviously.
Sì, che so, spande, però principalmente sui vini greci.
So in general, it's just wineries that I like, wine or grape varieties that I appreciate, and that's I don't want to limit myself in any other way or form, except do I like the wine and the people that produce it. I think that's the most
perché non può essere una generalizzazione poi anche in futuro ma proprio specializza sui vini o produttori che gli piacciono generale.
Because wine also obviously has to create some sense of community as well between people. Mm-hmm. So that's the main
sì, creare questa sorta di comunicazione che poi comunità tra le persone dal vino.
Ok.
Yeah, so then you will create a sort of communication that then go on, we can say.
Exactly. And also during, I mean, if it's Corona is a bit, makes everything a bit, little bit tricky in terms of on-site documentary interviewing.
Vorrebbe farlo dal vivo, cioè per quello anche il programma di fare questo viaggio.
Quindi lui inizia un racconto, cioè nel senso che poi è un racconto che andrà avanti, diciamo, un po' a puntate, no?
So if we are understanding well, is a sort of tale, no? That then you are doing sort of episode, we can say, that
exactly.
will go...
In the end, yes. In the end, it should be about smaller stories fitting into a larger story. And also when I do... If it does happen that I will be traveling from Croatia to France and Germany, obviously there will be multiple smaller episodes in the course of those couple of weeks that sort of tie together in a certain wine route or wine philosophy.
Sì, che quindi saranno più, diciamo, episodi poi anche in generici o in più grandi racconti, però se appunto farà questo viaggio dalla Croazia a Germania fino a venire qua, racconti possono essere legati alla zona oppure alle filosofie, comunque puntate, diciamo, sì.
Bene, bene, quindi quando lui organizza questo viaggio ce lo dice, così magari diamo una mano a organizzare...
Altre tappe.
Altre tappe qua, i ristoranti.
Marco was saying that Then when you organize the trip for sure, so you know that you are traveling, maybe if you want or you need some suggestion, even for restaurants or places,
absolutely, yes,
close by, we will be happy to help you doing that.
Sounds good. I'm looking forward to it.
Sure. Yeah. It will be nice for us.
Yeah. Let's do that. Absolutely. Well, then for now, I'd say thank you so much for your time and effort.
To you.
Obviously, for your wine in the first place. And I'll drink to the next 50 years or something like that.
Thank you.
To take in formato,
see, if you publish something or do something, if you share with us or tell us.
I will let you know, of course.
I share with you a short video that we have finished. So, well, the guys that work with us, that take care of our website and whatever, we had a short video that is from the vineyards to the labeling. So
it's just one, not even two minutes.
I will send you.
Yeah, just send it. Yeah.
Se, perfect. Se poi vuole qualcosa di particolare, te lo dice, tu glielo mandi.
Yeah, and if you need or you want something specific, even about process, you can tell us. We have some materials, or we can create some, and we can send it to you.
Yeah, we will be in touch. I guarantee you. And I'll say, see you next year live in person, probably.
We hope so.
Yeah.
Benvenuto.
Thank you again. Grazie.
Ciao. Mille.
Grazie.
See you soon.
Buona vita. Good life.
Good life.